Okay, Mr. Angelo Perilla, how do you feel about politics and commercial in karting nowadays?
What is the situation now?
Well, is there also the politics and the commercial activity?
Look, the situation, in my personal opinion, is that the CIK in the last few years, they've done this KH model and this and that, and don't work.
The KF engine?
KF, it's too expensive. Far too expensive. The normal race cost a fortune. The engine cost a fortune, everything cost a fortune. I think that now that Chris Van de Green is vice president and Chris know karting very well from a long, long time because he started like a mechanic and like driver, helping Landia, helping Peter De Bruyne, so you know the story. We have to go back. We have to go back to some kind of simple rule and simple engine and cheap, reasonable cheap, acceptable.
Yeah. So what you're saying really is karting is getting too complicated, too expensive.
Exactly.
We got to go back to the basic?
We have to go back to the original idea. Like the Americans say, karting is a family sport. The father drive or the boy drive, the mother make the barbecue, simple like this. And that is the concept that start karting, and we have to go back to this sport. I've been in America several times, probably 60, 70 times, more perhaps. And it's totally different, totally different.
The way they
go around and the class that they have and everything different. They make like a family sport, really.
Small party.
Exactly.
A holiday.
Exactly.
And here we have all the stress with the teams and...
We have big van and we have this and we have that and we have been on the wrong way.
And since when do you have the feeling that started here in Europe, that very high level karting? Is it something from the last 10 years or is it something that started in 1960 already?
No. In 1960 everyone started his own go-kart frame by motorcycle engine, the Rumi or the other put on and go and play go-kart on the street because there was no track. 1970 again, in the beginning of that we had a Volkswagen van and everybody have a Volkswagen van, no problem at all. In 1980, when I raced a world title, we had the two van, but something like a Mercedes van, nothing else. And we had probably Ayrton, Terry, Giacoletto, four or five drivers.
So the big names and a lot of drivers.
Exactly. Two van was enough. And we had probably 10 frame and 50 engine tires. We don't need the DeLorean, no. The Formula One, and this and that, no.
And that's something from 1990 and so on.
Starting 90, the first one was Beer, if I remember well, 1989, 1990.
BRL.
Yeah. The first was Beer, later was Tony, later was CRG, and this and that.
The big companies.
But now it's extinct that they, like, soon I think, some big van will be disappear.
Yeah.
Soon.
Yeah, the way they're going now. I think there are companies in financial problems.
Mm. Not just one.
Not just one. So that's the downside of.
It's simple. When you have 10 mechanics, sorry, 10, 30 mechanics, two van and presentation and this and that, you have a cost that is no more acceptable. So you have to find a boy. A driver that probably you have to charge 150,000 to 200,000 euros per season.
Yeah.
Per season. Yeah. It's not so easy. Okay, sometimes you can have two Chinese, another time you can have two Russian, another time you can have a Japanese, but
somewhere it stops.
Not very often.
No.
Or not every year. No. That is the problem.
Yeah. So when they lose their drivers.
That plus there is another problem that before if you have to drive a Formula 3 or Formula Ford, you must be 18. Now you must be 14.
Yeah. So they cart less.
Exactly.
So that's something VIA or CIK has to
I think CIK have to protect the hobby driver, the driver to make four race in a season, national race, that is a protect. Yeah. There is no sense, in my personal opinion, to protect the KF class. The KF class is a disaster. Yeah. All the company who produce the KF, Pagname, Cergi, Tony, at the moment they don't sell the engine, they rent the engine. Yeah. But when you have spent 2 million euros probably, because by the time that you make the molds, the drawings, the prototype, everything, the production is 2 million euros. And after that you spend 2 million euros, you rent the engine. Yeah. No, you have to sell the engine.
You don't get your money then.
That is the problem. Yeah. Plus, the KF engine or rules has done really quick, so nobody know what was exactly the rules. The first engine from many companies was a disaster, so they have to throw away.
Yeah, make everything new, even
more cost. Exactly. And at the end of the story, we reach the point that an engine costs 3,500 euros.
Yeah. We see a lot of drivers nowadays, even first year in their career, competing in European championships or world championships, and not driving a national championship.
Exactly.
How do you think about that?
That is wrong. That is totally wrong. At the time of Ayrton, or the year something between 1970 to 1982-83, you must race national, and the national federation give you the access to the European Championship or World Championship. Yeah. But you must have point or championship point or any kind of quotation in national race. Yeah. Without this, you cannot go to the World Title, and that sounds good.
That's the way it should be.
And there was place in the beginning was place for only 4 people,
per country.
For country. Later they opened to 6, but in the beginning was 4.
Yeah. And now they leave it completely open. Okay.
In fact, there was a problem. To give you an example, England probably at that time had 8 real good drivers, but there was place for 4.
Yeah.
Also Holland. Holland was. Peter Kuno, Fred Kuno, Peter De Bruyne, Harm Schurman, there was another guy, Eddie Van De Hoek, but there was place for 4.
Yeah.
Now, the race is just European Championship, like world title or USK,
yeah,
no 15 sense.
15 drivers per
company. Exactly. No, yeah. Exactly. Now I hope that the new kids come on the green, that no karting have to change something. And probably know that they have to change something. Because if you look at CIK, there is not a cheap class. Everything expensive. Everything became expensive.
Yeah.
Too far expensive. Plastic everywhere. You destroy the plastic every meeting.
Yeah.
It's not just the plastic. The plastic, the decals,
yeah.
Every meeting, you have to throw away.
Yeah. There's no end.
No, I don't think. I think really, I hope that Kiss can change the story.
Yeah. Well, we hope so.